Next Friday, the Longhorn Network goes live to bring University of Texas sports to Longhorn fans 24 hours a day.
The 20-year, $300 million deal between sports giant ESPN and UT is really the first of its kind.
Which is why tonight our sports director, Randy McElvoy, is going to take a closer look at those for and against this new network.
The Longhorn Network hasn't even hit the air yet, and already both sides of the issue are fired up. Fans are happy. Rivals, not so much.
A&M's and other schools have a point. It's a valid point, and it is going to be quite a recruiting tool.
For a while, they were going to go forward with televising high school games. Folks have stepped in and said, no, that's not going to happen. Do you see that as a recruiting advantage that they can pick high school games?
Absolutely. I mean, you have a high school kid who plays at a certain school, yet he's already a star. He was a star on the Longhorn Network, and he hasn't even left high school.
North Shore head coach David Amon has sent more than a few players to college ball.
It's going to be interesting to see if the NCAA steps in and has a policy in that regard.
Get televised, and your parents can see you, your family and friends can see you every game. That is a huge recruiting tool.
Recruiting analyst Matt Malatesta says what will be a hurdle for scoring athletes may just well be the finish line for the conference.
You think this Longhorn Network, in a roundabout way, can be the epicenter, basically, of potentially dismantling the Big 12?
The Big just keep getting bigger, and they're the biggest on the block in the state of Texas and virtually in the country. They're, like I said, on the cutting edge of doing this with the Longhorn Network televising every game. This is the beginning of the end of the Big 12, I think.
Malatesta is not alone on that thought. The head of Rice's sports management program, Clark Haptonstall, says at first it was the boost in pay from the Big 12 restructuring. And now this.
That's really an uneven playing field now for the rest of the Big 12, and that's, I think, why the other schools are looking at it is, I don't know how we're supposed to be able to compete with a school that is getting $25 to $30 million more a year than we are in television revenue.
And then there is the issue of fair play on ESPN.
For ESPN to now have a business interest in seeing a university succeed was really conflicting to me.
With 7 days to go, even the Longhorns in the Longhorn Network aren't completely sure what's part of the program.
We're all wondering if they show practice, what does that mean? How can you show practice without showing formations or defensive alignment? So there's still a lot of things that we've got to work out.
Playing it by ear appears to be the only game plan right now.
A year from now, we'll all know what it means.
And this week, perhaps a sign of the times, Kansas State started their own online HD network. It's a less costly move and a great option for schools looking for exposure. And you know, NBC and Notre Dame have made it work for a number of years now, and nobody seemed to have a problem with it. In Missouri City, Randy McElvoy, KPRC Local 2.
So far, no major cable providers have signed on to carry the Longhorn Network, which is expected to be bundled in a sports package. The experts we talked with said they expect it to be a last-minute deal.